Okay, I welcome you once again for the poem My Mother at 66, composed by Kamala Das. In the previous clip video, we read all about the poetess summary and along with the poetic device used in the poem. So here on we read about the important question of the poem. The poem composed in blank verse. The poem My Mother at 66 is composed in blank verse. It expresses the anguish of a daughter over her mother's advancing age and the fear of permanent separation from her. Permanent separation, death. So what is the kind of pain and the age that the poetess feel? What kind of pain? The pain of losing her mother. There is always a dilemma in the heart of the poetess that whether she may lose her mother. She is the childhood fear of the poetess. कि कहीं वो अपनी मदर को खो ना दे, ये जो भावना है वो उसके मन में रहती है. And she, you know, feel that pain or ache at each and every moment. So the poetess outlook here on is that she doesn't her mother want to be lost. She has a familiar pain since the childhood that whether she may lose her mother. The question here on why are the trees described as sprinting? Why are the trees described as sprinting? You know, it is a general phenomenon. When we travel in a vehicle, the trees must sprint backwards. Really, trees doesn't sprint, but it is obviously, it seems to us that trees are sprinting backwards. But here, the image is given by the poetess to create the contrast. The image is here to create the contrast. You know, young trees. The trees are mentioned as young. The poetess sees towards her mother and she is in decaying stage. So she wanted to create the contrast. That's why she looked towards outside and sees the trees sprinting backwards. So it is totally to create the contrast. The second, another question. Why has the poet brought the image here, another image of merry children spilling out of their homes? ये एक अलग से इमेज है, मेरी चिल्ड्रन स्पिलिंग आउट ऑफ देयर होम्स. एज फार एज द पोएटेस सीज टुवर्ड्स हर मदर, सी इज एजिंग, डिके, पैसिविटी, एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड चिल्ड्रन आर वेरी गे एंड हैप्पी. ओके, लेट्स सी द कॉन्ट्रास्ट. व्हाइल सी इज लुकिंग टुवर्ड्स हर मदर इज टोटली एजिंग, डिके एंड फुल ऑफ पैसिविटी एंड सी हैज अ वेरी डल फेस. On the other hand, while she looks towards outside the window, she sees the children, many children spilling out of their arms. And these children are full of hope, full of youth, full of energy and full of enthusiasm. So she wanted to create the contrast. She wanted to divert the attention towards her mother because she doesn't want to look in a manner where she can frustrate herself. So there is another question. You have to learn, why has the mother been compared to late winter swoon? Here there is comparison of mother's face with late winter's mouth. First, I would like to tell you that the face of mother is dull, obscure, hazy, and you know, it loses the charm or beauty. In the same manner, in the late winter, moon is also became hazy. It also became obscure. It also loses its brightness. So there is very apt comparison between the poetess mother and the moon. हम क्या कहेंगे कि जो poetess का चेहरा है उसको कवियत्री किस प्रकार से describe करती है कि वो brightness को उसमें brightness नहीं है, obscure है, धुंधला है, उसके अंदर जो है चमक नहीं है, वो बहुत ज्यादा एक तरीके से passive बन गया है, उसमें aging दिखाई दे रही है, passivity दिखाई दे रही है, उसी प्रकार से वो अपना charm खो चुका है. और late winter moon में जो moon की condition होती है वो भी absolutely similar to the face of the mother. So we can say the mother's face being compared to the late winter's moon, it is very apt and appropriate because there are so many similarity between the two. What do the parting words? What do the parting words of the poetess? And what it signifies? Parting words. The parting words in the poem are "See you soon, Amma." The parting words in the poem are "See you soon, Amma." And what it signifies? It signifies that the poetess doesn't want her mother to be emotional. The poetess doesn't want her mother to be emotional. She simply says, "See you soon, Amma." And after that, she keeps smiling. It is not a real smile from the heart of the poetess. Okay? She hides her feeling. She doesn't want her mother to be emotional. She just tried to hide her feelings and wanted to give a message to her mother that everything is okay. So, she says that, "See you soon, Amma." And after that, she starts smiling for a long time. Okay? After that, where is the poetess going? There may be another question. Where is the poetess going and who is with her? The poetess is going towards the Cochin airport. And who is with her? The poetess mother is with her. She is with open mouth, doors, and her face is just like a sun. So you answer simply the question that where is the poetess and who is with her? Where is the poetess going and who is with her? The poetess is going towards the Cochin airport and the poetess mother is along with her. She is in a very bad condition. She is very full of dullness, lose the brightness, with open mouth, aging, decay, passivity. Okay? There may be another question. Describe the poetic device in the lesson, in the poem, sorry. The poetic device मैंने अभी आपको बताया था, तीन चार poetic imagery है, सबसे ज्यादा personification है, metaphor है और simile है. Why does the poet put that thought away? Why does the poet? Why does the poet put that thought away? Why does the poetess put that thought away? और वो thought है क्या? Why does the poetess put that thought away? And look outside. The thought of losing her mother. The thought of permanent losing her mother. It is a very, you know, the fact from the heart of the poetess. She considers herself that it is the possibility that her mother may not survive when she returned from abroad. So, she simply wanted to put that thought away. It's the thought of losing her mother. It's the thought of seeing her mother in such a state. That's why she looked outside the window. What does the poet do after the security checker? There may be another question, that what does the poet do after the security checker? After the security checker, that was the exact time to depart. So she looked towards her mother once again, and she was full of emotions, but she doesn't reflect those emotions. She just keeps smiling, says a single phrase that see you soon, Amma, and after that keeps smiling. But let me tell you, that was not the real smile from the heart of the poetess. The only fact behind this smile is that she doesn't, her mother wants to be very emotional. These are the important questions from the poem.